Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at exporting photos from iPhoto. You have a few ways to get photos out of iPhoto, but in this video let's focus on using the standard file export function. So first let's go into an event here and select a few photos. I'm going to select three photos like that, and I'm going to do file export. And we have a variety of options that appear then. The one we're going to focus on is the file export for just getting the actual photo files out of iPhoto. Normally they're stored in a package, which is the iPhoto library. So to get them out as files, to say to put them on a USB device or email them to friends or do something else with them, you would want to use this file export function after selecting several photos. Of course, a simpler way to do it would be simply to drag and drop the photos out of iPhoto into the Finder. But this offers you more options about exactly how the export's going to work. So you can see the main options. The first one is to select the kind. And typically when you export a photo, you want to export it as a JPEG. But often you want to do original. So when you do original, you're actually taking the original photo. So this is how it came from your camera into iPhoto in the first place. It's the full size one, so it may be several megs and may not be ideal for, say, emailing somebody or giving somebody a large collection of photos. But if you really want to give them the original, the highest quality version, then you want to use original here. And usually that is a JPEG because that's what most cameras nowadays save. But if you switch to JPEG, you get more options, like you can adjust the quality because you're no longer restricting it to only giving you the original photo. So now you can set it to several different options. And here you can see the lowest, the smallest size. That's usually good for sharing something online or just giving a quick copy to a friend so they can see it. But if they want to keep the photo and use it, then if you're not going to use original, then perhaps use maximum, which will basically recompress the photo a little bit, maybe saving a little space, but still try to maintain almost all the quality. Then you've got two qualities in the middle there you can use for various things. Now, as an experiment, I took a photo and I exported it in six different ways. The first way here you can see is using the low setting. In the low setting, you can see I got it down to 1.1 megs, which if I go to the original, I jump there, so this is exporting with the original setting, you can see that it's a 4.6 meg photo. So I save a lot of space by doing low. And you can see the picture size is still the same, 3264 by 2448. Either way, it's just compressing it differently. So if I look at it here in quick look, you can see there's the one version of it, and if I were to go down to the original, you could see you really don't see much of a difference at this screen resolution. If I zoomed in, you would see a difference. It depends upon how much you care about that quality, whether or not it matters to you. Because if I go from low to medium, you can see I jump to 2.1 megs, and then I go to high, it goes to 3.8, just barely saving over the original. And if I go to maximum, it actually is recompressing it at a higher rate. You're not getting anything out of that, so there's no point using maximum in this case, although it may make sense for another photo, perhaps a much larger one. But in this case, maximum, you're actually getting a larger file but no new quality because you can't get quality out of it. So if I do the drag and original, notice that it's the same thing. So exporting original and dragging are actually basically doing the same thing. So you can see if you're using JPEG, you can also decide whether or not to include some data in the photo, like the title and keywords or location information with the photo. This is useful especially if you're exporting to archive something somewhere or send somebody an original photo. You know, take a photo of them and, oh, send me a copy. And you may want to include that GPS information in there so they have that when they import it into their iPhoto collection. If you switch to something like original, you don't get those options because that's automatically included. Also, when you go using JPEG export, you get to choose the size. So I was using full size, and you notice that all of the different options were saving at the same dimensions. But I can actually shrink the photo down, and I can use small, medium, large, or full size, or custom, and then set it to a maximum width or height, or either one. So I can basically select the size of the photo. And this is great especially for uploading to websites where you're not going to ever see the photo at full resolution anyway, so why have a huge file to upload? Or say if you're an artist and you want to provide a sample of your work, you can provide a smaller sample very easily. And for web development work as well, you don't want to necessarily have the full size image, which is going to take a long time to download. So you have those options. You also get to choose a file name, whether you use the original file name, which is usually a letter followed by some numbers from that your camera gave it. And then you also get to set it to the title. So in this case you can see like I've set a title for this photo here, but these are just using the original file name, so it wouldn't make any difference. You can just say, just do a sequential one. I'm going to export a bunch of different ones, and I just want it to be like, you know, ABC and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can rename them that way and use the album name for this, in this case sample photos, with the number sequentially after that. You also get to pick a subfolder format. So if in this case you're selecting several events, let's do that here. I can select a couple of events here and I do export for both of those events. I can say, yeah, create subfolders, one for each event, and use the event name for that. Otherwise, don't use subfolders. I find myself using the export function mostly if I want to upload a bunch of photos to a web gallery of some sort, or I want to share them with somebody, like put them on a USB stick or transfer them over a network for someone. And I want to set specifics, like maybe just give them medium quality because I know they're not going to save the photos. They're just going to look at them that one time and not add them to their collection. If I do want to give somebody some photos for them to keep permanently, then I would give them the originals, perhaps using the drag and drop option, or at least exporting using the original setting. Hope you found this video useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.